y que le cela no, que le manacele, cola mancela si, cole mamanacelo solo ni, que le macela la no son, cole macela la no no. I surrender all to you, my God, and my King. I surrender you to Lord, my God, my everything. I surrender all to you, my best friend. Lord, I know that you are with me till the end. I know that you are with me till the end. Hi, everyone. My name is Patricia, and I'm here at the Shield Church tonight in Rock Hill, South Carolina, with Pastor Larry Souls. And I'm excited that we're here tonight because I believe tonight that God is going to touch you and change you in a way that you never expected tonight. Because we pray tonight, we actually going to pray about the word surrender. But before we get started, I just want to sing the song that talks about surrender. And I want you tonight, as you listen to this song, that you will just say, God, I just give you everything. Everything that's bothering me, everything that's trying to overwhelm me, everything that trying to bring me in fear and doubt and unbelief and anxiety. God, I just want to surrender my life to you. I just want to surrender everything that's in me, everything that's about me. God, I want to surrender it to you. You may say, well, what does the word surrender is? Surrender means to give oneself up into the power of another. To give oneself up into the power of another. When you think about surrendering, sometimes you think about a war between two nations or a war between a person and one person, two people fighting, whether for the same thing or against different things. But ones always surrender to the earth, like they give in, they yield to another person. But tonight, we want to use the word surrender. To give oneself up to the power of another is to understand that that's what God wants us to do tonight. That's what he wants you to do is just talk to him about your problems. Talk to him about your situation. Tell him. It's not like he doesn't already know. Tell him how you feel. It's not like he doesn't already know. But yet when you come to him and you tell him, you talk to him and you say, God, I feel this way. And God, I know that it may be wrong for me to feel this way, but God, I give it to you. I surrender my situation to you. I surrender my life to you. I surrender my heart to you. I surrender my soul to you. Because God, I know that you are the only one that can help me. Another definition says the action of yielding one's person or giving up the possession of something, especially into the power of another. See, surrender is always about surrendering to a power of another person. And when you look at your life today and you're like walling around in the mud or walling around in the dirt where there's just mud and you just don't know where to turn and just can't see a clear path. But I believe tonight that God is saying, I just want you to come to me and surrender. Surrender your heart. Surrender your situation to me. And as you begin to do that and begin to trust God, that God is the answer, that he is the solution, that he is the problem solver, and that he longs to be that in your life. Why? Because he's God. And beside him, there is none other. He is awesome. He's wonderful. He's great. He is so worthy to be praised and worshiped and adored. But before we pray tonight, I just want to sing just a few choruses of this song. And it's called All to Jesus, I Surrender. All to Jesus, I Surrender. All. To me, all means all. Everything that concerns you, God said he will perfect it. Everything that's concerned you, he wants you to surrender it to him. You know, this song every once in a while ringing through my heart today, and I believe this because maybe things I'm going through, just God says, like, give it to me, Patricia. Just give it to me. Give it to me. You can't handle it. You can't solve it. You know, you can't. One thing about other people is that if other people is involved in a situation, you cannot change that person. You cannot change that person, but you can't change yourself. You can't change your attitude. You can't change your mindset. You can't change yourself to believe that, you know what? This person, I can't change their opinion. I can't change what they're talking about. I can't change, but I can change me. And it doesn't have to come and steal my joy and my peace. So when we give, we surrender to God. God said, give it to me. Give it. What do you do when you give? You reach something out to someone and you say, here, this is yours. This is yours. And that's what God wants us to do tonight, guys. He wants us to turn our hearts to him, to surrender to him. Whatever you may be experiencing, surrender it to him. But this title of the song is All to Jesus, or I Surrender All. The title is I Surrender All. Not just a little bit, but all, everything. Give him everything. Just say, Lord, okay, I'm going to lay it on the table and I'm going to give it to you. I'm going to give it to you tonight. The song goes like this. It says, all to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily live. All to Jesus I surrender humbly at his feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. All to Jesus I surrender. Make me Savior, wholly thine. Let me feel the Holy Spirit, truly know that thou on mine. I surrender all. I surrender all. All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily live. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. To thee, my blessed Savior, I surrender all. See, tell him tonight that you want to give him all, that you don't want to carry it anymore, that the burden is too heavy. The rock is like too heavy that's coming upon you tonight. The thoughts is too overwhelming. You know, it's like the world is like you cave, something is caving in inside of you tonight. Tell him, say, God, I surrender all to you. I surrender all. I give it all to you. And Lord, as I give it to you, Lord, I ask you to make me wholly thine. Help me to cast all of my cares upon you. When I think about the word cast, it's like taking a rock and you cast it out into the sea of unforgiveness, where it's just cast it out. You know, it's almost like Jesus, when he forgave us of our sins, he cast them away. It's like he forgets about them. But your problems tonight, he's concerned about them because you're concerned. So if you have any prayer requests tonight, please just email it to us at prayer.7shield@gmail.com. prayer.7shield@gmail.com. And we'll be more than happy to pray with you, because we believe tonight that if we surrender our lives to God, as we surrender our problems to God, that we don't have to think about them all day long. We don't have to go to night, the bed at night, and wake up in the morning with the same stress of wondering how it's going to happen, what's going to happen, and all these things that go through our mind, because it's trying to bring us under and in this captivity. But I believe tonight, when we surrender, we're not only talking about surrendering our life to him, but as we surrender, we're able to help others. No matter what you're going through tonight, everybody go through things, I know, but no matter what you're going through tonight, I believe God telling you tonight, just surrender the situation to him. Surrender to him and just talk to him and ask him to give you strength. Ask him to give you wisdom. Ask him to give you the knowledge of whatever you may be going through. That even though you're going through, but you're not going through defeated. You're not going through down. You're going through it up. You're not going through it without peace. You're going through it with peace. You're not going through it without joy, because you realize that the joy of the Lord is my strength. And if you begin to feel that in your spirit begin to rise up, because your mind and your body, your flesh is telling you, no, you need to worry. You need to try to figure it out. You need to do this and you need to do that. But you know what? Sometimes we have to talk to our mind, and we have to say, no, mind, you shut up, because you know what? The spirit is in control. Allow God to be in control. Allow the Holy Spirit to be in control of whatever situation you're going through. Allow him to guide you through these little steps. You know, even today, when I was with another godchild, and I was putting him in the car, and his parent had bought a new car seat. And I figured probably about 5 minutes trying to figure out, how in the world do I put this child in this car seat? How do I, you know, get the straps on, because it seemed like it was so tight, or how do I unloose the button so I can put him in? You know, it seems like something so simple, right? It's like it just, you know, just hit the button, it goes, right? But it didn't. It's like, I'm like, wow, what's the matter? And I was like, Holy Spirit, I just don't know how. And all of a sudden, he just showed me how. It just happened. I'm like, man, Holy Spirit, you're so cool. You're so nice. You're so wonderful. And just all week long, just little things that I don't know what to do or how to do, he just give me wisdom. It's like he just bring to my attention, do this or do it this way, or show me something, another different way of doing it. You know, that's what the Holy Spirit is. And you know, this song, when the songwriter wrote it, I believe that songwriter was really going through some things, and he's like, I want to surrender my life to God. I believe he had a revelation of what it really means to surrender. To give it all up. God, I give it all up for you. You know, I can imagine like Peter and Paul, and when Paul was called to go on the road to Damascus, and you know, was blind and went to and got prayed for. And you know, I believe that even during that season in his life, you know, he's like, God, Jesus, I was destroying you, but now I know, Jesus, that you are the Savior. You are true, what they was talking about. There's truth to this calling, a truth to this story, what they was talking about. And I believe that as Paul began to, Saul at that time, I believe as he began to be in that situation, be in that atmosphere with God for about 3 days. And when and Ananias came to pray for his blindness was left. You know, I believe that in that time of his season, I believe he was like, you know, God, you know what? I'm sorry, but I want to surrender my life to you. And you know, Paul didn't know what the situation was going to be. He didn't know what he had to go through to surrender his life to God. He didn't know the challenges, all the challenges he would have. He knew it would be some, but he didn't know to the depth of what it was. But yet, Paul made that decision. God, I surrender my life to you. My life belongs to you. You're the one that gave me breath. You're the one that gave me my eyes and my hands and that I can be an instrument for you. You're the one that did that. So when you begin to look at that particular situation, even with Paul and how he surrendered himself, what did he do? He gave himself up to the power of another. He said, God, you know what? This is what I am. I'm just a man and, you know, and in my own way of living, I can't do anything without you. And that's what he wants us to feel tonight, that we can't do anything without God. We can't do anything without the Holy Spirit. We can't do anything without Jesus. We can't. And when we make our mind say, Lord, I surrender to you, then you mean that whatever problem you're going through tonight, whatever situation that you're going through tonight, whatever pain that you're going through tonight, whatever anxiety or fear that you may be going through tonight, whatever family problem with the children or with the husband or with the wife or on your job or anything that concerns you tonight, God says it concerns me. And because it concerns him, he wants you to surrender. Surrender means to give. Freely give it up. Freely give it up. Don't hold on to it. Don't hold on to your past in such a way that it's destroying you. But God says, give me that past. Give me that situation that happened years ago. Give it to me. Let me show you how to walk through it. Let me show you how to. I can bring you out. Let me show you how I can set you free from it. Why? Because he wants us to be free, to be the people of God that he called us to be. And as we can be that and continue to be that and begin to act like that and begin to walk like that, then what happens? We're able to help somebody else because people are really going through things. And no matter what situation you're in, God is there with you. He said he'll never leave you. He will never forsake you. Why? Because he loves you. So I pray for you tonight that the God, the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, that same Spirit that lives inside of you, if you have already accepted Jesus into your life. But if you haven't accepted him into your life, I ask you right now to think about asking him to come into your life. Asking him to forgive you of your sins. Asking him, telling him that you believe that he is the Son of God and he is the Savior of the world, and you want him to come live inside of you. You want him to come live inside of you because you're so tired of being tired of where you are at. You're so tired of being in this situation. You're so tired of feeling like you're overwhelmed. You're so tired of putting the fake smile on when really inside you're hurting. You're hurting, not just physical hurting, but emotionally hurting. You're hurting. So we begin to pray and begin to ask God. Tell God, say, Lord, I surrender this. I give this up to you, God. I give it to you because I can't handle it. I don't want to carry it any longer because I wasn't made to do that. And you know what, guys? He will take it. Why? Because you were not made. Your body wasn't made to have stress that so weighed so much upon you that it makes you sick. That it makes you oppressed, that it makes you depressed, that it makes you like so out of the world, like crazy because you don't know which way to turn. And everywhere you turn, it seems like it's the wrong way. But Jesus is the right way. He really is. So Father, tonight I pray for everyone that's listening tonight that the word surrender means to give oneself up into the power of another, that they will yield. I pray tonight that they will yield their life to you. And as they yield their life to you, Father God, that they will begin to give up one by one, whatever is in their mind tonight, whatever is in their heart tonight, they will begin to give it up and give it to you and say, Lord, I give you, I belong to you. Because the Bible says that we are the temple of the Holy Spirit. We are the temple. Animals are not the temple. We are the temple. People that says that Jesus lives inside of them. The people that says that Jesus died for me and I receive his salvation. I receive it in his name. I receive that. I ask him to come in my heart. See, he died for you. He died for the world, but everybody in the world would not accept him. Everybody in the world would not listen to him. So, but if you listen to him tonight and you send yourself, look, Patricia, I want to surrender. I want to surrender. I want to go to bed tonight and I want to surrender everything. Tomorrow you can just surrender whatever you may decide. But make up your mind tonight that God, I give it to you. And I ask you for the wisdom of where I need to go from here. What I need to do. What steps I need to make. What scriptures do I need to read to stand upon? Because I understand that the enemy try to come back. But Lord, I want my joy. I want my peace. I do. I want my joy. I want my peace. Why? Because it's mine. It's mine for the asking. And you know, when he created me, he didn't create me without peace. He didn't want me to live a life without peace. So no matter what you're going through, he wants you to have that peace. He wants you to have that joy. He wants that joy of the Lord to be your strength. So I pray tonight that the joy of the Lord be your strength, that the same spirit that raised Jesus from the dead that lives inside of you, that same spirit brings joy. He doesn't bring sorrow and pain. He brings joy. He brings wisdom in Jesus' name. He gives you revelation, things that you don't even know, or he revealed things to you in such a way that you didn't even know they could be revealed that way. Why? Because it's by the Spirit. See, the Spirit understands the Spirit, but sometimes we can walk and live in our head. And when we do that, we're on the earthly level of ourselves, of our world. We walk in with the earthly level, but God don't want us to work on the earthly level. He wants to come up here with you. He wants to come up here with him. He wants you to come up. Come up means to come up and think like I'm thinking. What am I saying about your situation? What am I saying that I can do for you? What did the Bible, what did the world say? What did the world says about your situation? Why? Because he wants us to come up, think like he thinks. Everybody can think down. Everybody can think the worst in every situation. But you know what? God is asking us today that you begin to think higher. What is God saying about your situation? And allow him to work in your life. Psalms 34 says it like this. He says, David says, I will bless the Lord at all times. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. My soul shall make its boast in the Lord. The humble shall hear of it and be glad. Then it says, oh, magnify the Lord with me and let us exalt his name together. But he says, I will bless the Lord at all times. If you read about the story of David, you saw so many things that he went through. I mean, with his children, with the enemies and all this, just being a king wasn't like just every day going, everything, no problems at all. No, David had situations. He had things he had to take care of. And he had enemies that was after him. But yet David says, I will bless the Lord at all times. To me, all times mean all times. You know, he's like, I'm going to do it every day. Whether he did it 7 times a day, but your praise is going to be always on my lips. His praise shall continue to be in my mouth. His praise, meaning what? Mean that I'm going to continue to praise him. So when you praise him when things are going, it's easy to praise him when things are going good. It's easy to say, you know what, God's really been good to me because he blessed me with this. He blessed me with this. I got beautiful children, got a beautiful home, got a beautiful job. But when things begin to be pulled up, the rug begin to be pulled from under you, then what do you think? Well, he's the same God. He is the same identical God that when you blessed him when you was doing good, the same God you can bless him when it seems like things not going good. But see, in his mind, he's thinking it's going good. He's thinking that you may be going through this particular situation, but he's not worrying. He's not crying about it because he knows what he's going to do for you. He knows what he's going to do in you so he can walk that through you. See, he knows all of that. And David says, I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. I sought the Lord and he heard me and delivered me from all my fears. They looked unto him and were radiant and their faces were not ashamed. The poor man cried out and the Lord heard him. See, when you cry out to God, he'll hear you. He's just a whisper away. He's just a breath away. When you use that breath to cry out to him, he's right there with you. So I pray for you right now that the Spirit of God, the same Spirit that raised Jesus from the dead, the same Spirit that lives inside of you, I pray tonight that your spirit be quickened tonight in Jesus' name. I pray tonight that the Word of God become life to you in Jesus' name. I pray tonight that as David says, I will bless the Lord at all times, that the next time that you feel oppressed, the next time that you feel like you're defeated, the next time you tell yourself, this is not going to happen to me because, you know, nothing's good. It's not going to change. When the next time you even think that thought, I pray tonight that you replace it with a praise. You replace it with something that you can do. You replace it with something that you can shout about, something that you could tell somebody else about how good God is. Now, I remember a story about Benny Hinn. I think it was Benny Hinn when he went to pray for a young lady. Well, she was an older lady, but I called a young lady. He went to pray for her. And when he went to pray, she was really bedridden. She was sick. She was bedridden. But yet in her room where she was at, it's like the presence of God was there. She couldn't get up and walk. She couldn't get up and feed herself like we normally would do. But yet she had the presence of God in her room. So that let me know that no matter what you're going through, the presence of God can be with you. The presence of God can be so much with you that when somebody comes to pray for you or to talk to you, that presence of God is so much with you. They would minister to them. And you know what? And this young lady was like, you know, they wanted to pray for her. She says, no, because if you pray for me, then I may lose this presence that I'm in. The place that I'm in with him, I may lose it. And we were like, you think to yourself, well, why would you think you're going to lose it? Because she felt like her pain, her fears brought her closer to God. It didn't take her away, but the more she was suffering, the more she praised him, the more she worshiped him, the more she talked to him, the closer she got to him. And the closer she got to him, the more she felt his presence. And she loved the presence. So she eventually ended up praying for that person, praying for him. Because she felt like, you know, this is, I'm just stuck in his presence. She, you know what? I believe that she didn't even feel any pain. I believe that she knew that she couldn't get out the bed and walk. But I believe that his presence was so much around her that she just felt joy. She just felt peace. And she was just peaceful with where she was at. She had this happiness that so many people want. But happiness comes when you trust God. Happiness comes when you trust God. So I pray tonight that you have opened your eyes of your understanding, that God will open the eyes of your understanding, and that you will know the hope of his calling, that you will know that you're the head, not the tail, that you will know that you're above and not beneath, that you will know that you're blessed going in and blessed going out, that you know that he will never leave you, he will never forsake you, that you know that he was always on your side, that you know that he always hears your cry, if you cry out to him, that you know that he's not deaf and he cannot hear, but yet he's a God that doesn't sleep, not even 24/7, he doesn't sleep, that he's awake in the middle of the night. If you have to call upon him, he's awake. I pray tonight that you get a hunger and a thirst for God like never before. That when you go to bed at night, that you want to be with him, that you want to talk to him, that when you're in your car alone, that you want to talk to him. When you call with somebody in the car with you, that if you feel like talking to him, you'll talk to him. If you feel like humming a song, then you can do that. Why? Because you feel like God is with you. I pray tonight that God's Spirit will touch your body from the top of your head to the soles of your feet, and whatever spirit infirmity attack your body, that it has to go in Jesus' name. I call you healed by his stripes. By his stripes you are healed. Not because of my words I'm saying, but by his stripes that you are healed. And I'm saying the words that he has me to say. It's just not like words that don't mean anything. These words mean something. Why? Because it talks about him. It talks about Jesus and what he wants to do in your life, how he wants to raise you, how he wants you to be a testimony. What is a testimony for? What testimony talks about? What something you went through, right? Something that you went through, something you're going through, and your testimony, when you begin to tell it, you begin to tell what God has done. Begin to talk about what he's done in your life. Begin to talk about what he's done even though the things that you may seem want to happen right now, it's not done. But begin to talk about things he's already done. Think about the house that you're in, or the car that you drive, or the food that you're eating, or people blessing you in and out, or whatever it means, whatever it is. Begin to thank him for that. Gratitude gets God's attention. Murmuring and complaining doesn't. You know, I found that out years ago, and sometimes I still have to check myself because I still want to murmur and complain when things are not going right. But you know what, guys? I just ask God to forgive me for doing that and begin to trust him again. Begin to not look at the situation, but look at the God of the situation. Not to look at how big the thing is, but look how small it is in God's eyes. You know, when you learn to twist it around, then it's like, you know, you believe God, that God is really true, that God is awesome, he's wonderful, he's great, and he's there for you. He's right there before you. He's right near you. Just invite him in your situation. Invite him what you're going through. And you say, well, Patricia, I've done that. Continue to do it. Continue to do it. And continue to do it till you feel his presence, even in the middle of the night when you feel like you're so overwhelmed. But instead of being overwhelmed, you're overjoyed. You're overjoyed. You have over peace. You're like, where in the world did it come from? It came from being in his presence. It came from talking to him. Talk to God. Talk to him. Let him know that you love him tonight. Let him know that you appreciate him. Let him know that even though things sometimes doesn't seem like it's what you want to go through, but begin to say, God, I surrender my life to you. I surrender everything to you, God. And as you lead me and you guide me in the pathway that you have me to go. Because God, you know the plans that you have for me. Your plans is to prosper me, right? His plans is to prosper you and that you may have health and you may have good health. That's what his plans is. And so we can't look at the way things are. We have to look at what he says. Look, raise yourself up a little bit. Raise your eyesight up, spiritual eyesight up a little bit and begin to see what he says about the situation. What did God say? What did he say? And then you begin to continue to just talk to him and believe that he's God. And beside him, there's no other. Beside him, that he's loved you. He loves you so very, 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 very much. So very much. He's an awesome, awesome God. I pray that God would just, that the peace of God will rest and rule upon your life tonight. That the peace of God will rest and rule upon your life tonight. That the peace of God will rest and rule upon your life tonight. I pray that tonight that the joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. The joy of the Lord is your strength. And whatever you may have been experiencing, that joy begin to rise up inside of you, that you begin to feel it. It just begin to feel like inside of you, that joy that says, you know what? It's okay. It's going to be all right. That joy that says that like put a hug around a child, put a hug around a person, says, you know what? You can cry on my shoulder anytime you want to. And that's what God is saying to you tonight. Just give it to me. Surrender it all to me. And as you begin to do that, as I begin to do that, I realize that I'm giving oneself up to the power of another. I'm giving my problems up to the power of another. I'm giving my situation up to a power of another, a one that created me. The one that created me, the one that knew me before I was even conceived in my mother's womb, the one that saw me when I was conceived in my mother's womb. You know, I can't choose my mother, who my mother, my father was. But I can choose where I go from here. I can choose God as my father. I can choose him. That even when I feel like I need a mother advice, I still can choose him. So you can choose him for anything you may be experiencing in your life. And he's right there. Allow him to do that for you. Allow him to be there in your life. Allow him to talk to you tonight. Talk to him and listen to him. Listen to him. Talk to him. Talk to him. Listen to him. Because as you surrender, as you yield yourself to him, yield your emotions. Your emotions can be so out of whack. So out of whack because of all the things that are going through your mind. But you know what? I believe tonight that God is telling us that we can have the mind of Christ. And if we have the mind of Christ, when those thoughts become to come our way and they're not like God, that we quickly would know. We quickly be aware, quickly of those thoughts. And we can say, no, you're not coming to me tonight. We're not visiting tonight. We're not having a fellowship tonight. You got to go. And you begin to place it with the positive thoughts. Replace the negative with the positive. Replace the negative with the positive. Replace the negative with the positive. And if you do that, and as I do that, then what happens? We begin to see that, you know what? I'm learning to surrender. I'm learning to surrender it to you, God. And even though if I don't know how the answers to the question, how the situation may end, but I just want to be obedient to what he says. I just want to be obedient to what he says do. I just want to be obedient to the life that I'm called to live. And so are you. You can help so many people because you are born to do that. There's somebody waiting on you. There's somebody waiting on you to hear direction or hear a way out or just to love on them, to share God's love with them. God needs you. He needs you. He needs you, but it's not going to happen until we walk into surrender, until we walk in living a life, surrendering our life every day, believing that God is for me and not against me. Guys, I'm so glad that you joined us tonight. And I pray tonight that as you surrender your life to Jesus, that you surrender your heart to him, that you would know that he's for you, that he loves you. He loves you so very, very much, so very much that Jesus himself died for you. He died that you may have life and that you may have it more abundantly. He died that you may have life and that you would love it, that you would love life, that you would enjoy life, because life with him is so much better than life without. Because life with him says that I'm going to go through problems. I will have situations in my life. These things may come and these things may go. But hey, I still can enjoy my life. Why? Because enjoy means that I still have joy. But you know what? If you don't have him, and then if he's not in your life at all, and you don't know anything about him, then you're going through things and you can be so overwhelmed, so stressed out, and all these things, and you have nowhere to turn. But with Jesus, we have a way to turn. He is the way. He is the only way. He is the answer to your prayer tonight, to your whatever you need. He is the answer. Allow him to do that. Allow him to be that for you, because he really wants to do that. He really does. I'm going to end it once again with this song, I Surrender All. And I just want you, as we go off this air tonight, just keep the song in your mind. Just meditate on it. Think about it and realize that, hey, God is waiting on you. He's waiting on you. Allow him to work in your life. Allow him to be the God of your life. Allow him to do what he wants to do in your life tonight, because that's what he wants to do. All to Jesus I surrender. All to him I freely give. I will ever love and trust him in his presence daily live. All to Jesus I surrender, humbly at his feet I bow. Worldly pleasures all forsaken, take me, Jesus, take me now. I surrender all. I surrender all to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. I surrender all to you, Jesus. Just tell him tonight. I surrender all to you, Jesus. All to thee, my blessed Savior. I surrender all. Surrender all to him tonight. Know that he loves you. He really, really does. Thank you for joining us tonight at the Shield. Pastor Larry Souls, just thank you for joining us tonight. Praying for you that God would just touch you, heal you, deliver you, and that you would surrender your life totally to him in a way you never has before. If you want to join us on church Sunday mornings at 9:30, we have service starts at 9:30. Just come and join us and just be a part of the worship atmosphere here. It's wonderful, awesome, and enjoy the message that comes forth from the man of God, Pastor Larry Souls. And know that when you come expecting God to do something. Come expecting that God's going to touch your heart, that you will not leave this place like you came, in Jesus' name. Thank you for joining us tonight with Prayer Works. And we thank you, love you. You have a blessed week. And remember, as you surrender every little thing to God, he's right there to receive it. Yield to him.